my heart. Then there was humoresque, and now the Glass Menagerie. Now, how in the world do you master so many different accents?
I think I was born with an ear for accents, as I'm Irish on both sides from way back. The peg of my heart was a natural to me. My grandmother, who came from Ireland, lived with us, and that was a great help.
Well, your performance as Peg was one that's gone down in theatrical history.
I know, but my grandmother came to see the show, and she was disgusted. She said, "Sure, I don't know why they're paying you so much money for that kind of accent. There's lots of girls on the streets and in the churches of Ireland who could play the part just as well."
Well, now that you've turned on the brogue, why not continue it for us?
But you remember how Peg used to boast of her father? She used to say, "You know, sure, my father. My father can do anything at all, except make money. When times were the hardest, I never heard a word of complaint from his father. Sure, we were more like boy and girl together than father and daughter. And I never saw him cry but twice in my life. Once when he made a little money, and we had a mass said for my mother, and he had the most beautiful candles lit on Our Lady's altar. And then when I left him to come here, he laughed and joked with me up to the last minute, and when the ship swung away from the dock, he just broke down and sobbed like a little child. Oh, my Peg," he kept saying, "my little Peg. Sure, I wanted to get off that ship and go to him, but you know, I can't swim."
What a memorable scene that was. But how could you jump from that into such a convincing Jewish accent in Fanny Hurst's humoresque?
During the time I was studying the part of Sarah Cantor, I went to a little tailor shop run by a delightful little Jewess named Rosie. I just listened to her, and when humoresque opened, Rosie's voice was ringing in my ears when I said, "All the months before my children were born, I prayed that one should be a musicus. I thought at times the way our Isidore ran after the organ grinder, he would be the one. How could I know it was only the monkey he wanted? And now our little Leon, he wants for his birthday a fiddle. It's come, Papa, a musicus. He wants a violin, Papa.
And how the critics raved at that beautiful characterization. But now, tell us how you acquired your southern accent for The Glass Menagerie.
Well, the first time I read for the author, Tennessee Williams, he told me my accent was too thick. I said to him, "Why, Tennessee, I was just copying your own Mississippi doll." He said, "I haven't got any accent, Laurette." Well, I didn't contradict him. I left him safe in his illusion. But it's his accent that I use.
Well, Miss Taylor, I know that we, the people, are most eager to hear you in your role from the current hit, The Glass Menagerie. Oscar Bradley's orchestra will provide full bold Blue Mountain music for the play. Miss Taylor, in her role as a faded Southern belle, now poverty-stricken, recalls the glittering gaiety of her own girlhood. She speaks to her daughter.
"Laura, I wore this dress when I was a girl in Blue Mountain. It used to be lovely. It had bows and ribbons and tiny rosebuds on each ruffle. But they got more tired looking than the dress. I led the cotillion in it at the governor's ball at Jackson. Oh, my, Laura, you should have seen your mother sashay across that floor. I had this dress on when I met your father. Oh, that was a wonderful year. Invitations poured in from all over the Delta. I went to dances every evening, long rides in the country, and picnics in the afternoon. Oh, what lovely. Oh, my goodness. That country is so lovely in May. It's lacy with dogwood and flooded with jonquils. Every time I saw jonquils, I'd make the young gentlemen call, get out of the carriage, and help me pick them. Well, to tell you the truth, I got to be kind of a joke. The young men started to say, 'Look out for that girl, Amanda. If you cross her path, you'll spend the afternoon plucking jonquils.' Your father, jonquils. And now you, honey, you have jonquils, and you've got a young man coming to meet.